Hello friends, I am Mohammad Rafiq. Welcome to my YouTube channel Rafiq Engineering Drawing. In this video we will see second problem related to projections of plane by auxiliary method. This problem is similar to the third model of projections of plane inclined to one plane. In that I have solved with change of position method. Change of position method means front view top view first position, front view top view second position and front view top view third position. Three stages we were obtaining the projections, that is inclined to HP one, inclined to VP another. So three steps. This was the first step, was simple one. Now by auxiliary method we will save our time and we will try to implement it. Let us see the problem. What they are saying, this of course I'm telling once again, this is similar to the third model of projections of plane where I have solved. You can see in the playlist third model from projections of plane. Let us see, there I have used pentagon, here I am using hexagon, but position and orientation of plane are similar, not exact same. Okay, draw the projections of regular hexagon of side 30 mm is given, resting by one of its edges in VP. So assume this is one hexagon, hexagon edge, assume this is the hexagon edge is in the VP, and the surface of hexagon with respect to VP, it is making 45 degree, whereas the edge which is inside the VP is making with respect to HP at 60 degree. Okay, assume you have one hexagon like this, as I have given example of hexagon, the hexagon edge, that is take one edge of the hexagon, is inside the VP and the surface of hexagon with respect to VP is 45 degree, and the edge by which it is inside the VP is making some angle like this with respect to HP, 60 degree like that. Okay, so 30 mm side resting one of the edge in VP, the edge is inclined 60 degree to VP, means the edge by which it is resting, that edge only with HP it is 60 degree, whereas surface making an angle of 45 degree with VP. This is the question. Let us see how to solve this by auxiliary projection method or projection of plane by auxiliary method. So let us see. First, what we will do, whenever surface inclination is given with respect to VP or HP, that is secondary, surface inclination we will assume 0 and edge inclination we will assume 90 degree. So surface inclination 0 means like this, edge inclination earlier it was 60 degree, now 90 means the hexagon will be straight. And this is edge resting problem, so diagram will come like this. I will draw this diagram somewhere here. Edge resting means this is the diagram. Corner resting means the diagram will be like this. Okay, so this is your XY line and edge resting in the VP, that's why diagram is here. If edge resting is in the HP, then the diagram will come somewhere here. So this is not the case in HP, this is in VP. What edge, if it is corner in VP, here the diagram will be. So we will not discuss much other cases, we will come back to the problem. So edge resting in HP means the diagram will come here. This is the first question where I have taken edge in HP. This is the second question where I am taking edge in the VP. Okay. So now let us give some names A, B, C, D and E, F. Front view, so dashes will come. Project all the points for top view. So here we are getting the top view. So here looking from top, first comes A, then F, B, then E, C, then D. Okay, now what we will do, generally we will restore first surface angle 45. So we will take this line, same length, we will redraw it at somewhere here, continuing second step, 45 degree we will draw like this. Then what we will do, we will project all the points here, then here reduce hexagon we will be getting. Okay, but in auxiliary method we will not take it here, instead of rotating the object we will rotate XY line. So let us see how the diagram will be. I am taking new XY line like this somewhere here or like this, anywhere you can take it. Okay, now I will take the XY line somewhere here. Now I will use this color. Assume this is at How much inclination surface? 45 degree. We will draw here at 45 degree new hexagon. Instead of that, I have rotated x y line. Now this is at 45 degree. So now this is the top view. Front view will come here somewhere. Okay. So for front view purpose, you need to project this. Anyhow, it is on the line itself. This point and this point, you need to project on this line, such that the projector should intersect with this line at 90 degree. This and this should be 90 degree. In that way, we will project. So and then extend this after projection. So these are the extension of the projectors. Now what we will do? Whereas this is at 45 degree. Here I have marked the angle. Now measure distances. Which distances you need to measure? These distances. Point D distance we are measuring. Point D is here with respect to old x y. Now D distance will be here. Assume D is somewhere here. Then C distance will measure here, bigger distance, this one. And C is where? Here. C. From here you need to measure. Don't measure from here. Okay. Here measuring from here to here while transferring from here to here, you need to transfer. That is C, like this. Okay. Similarly, other points also, E, B, F, A, all those we will measure from this XY line to this distances. Then we will measure and transfer from this XY line. So what you are doing here, we are doing front view. So whenever you are doing top view, you will be getting auxiliary inclined plane. Whenever you are doing front view, you will be getting auxiliary vertical plane. Okay, so this is, we are doing front view. So this is auxiliary vertical plane. This is auxiliary vertical plane. Same, two sides I am writing. Now, by measurement, we have transferred all the points. I will join directly. So this is the way how we got. This is C and D. Now which one is C and D in this two? D is closer, C is far. So here also D will be the closer, C will be far. Already I have marked C. Okay. Then this will be E. This A bracket F are the older one which belongs to here. A bracket F. So this is F, A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. So this is the top view, as I said. So this is, will be the front view. So here dashes will come. A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E and F dash. Okay. This is the way how we have done. Now, what we will do? Edge by which it is resting, that edge with respect to HP is at 60 degree. Okay. So which edge is resting? This edge is resting because already it is making inclination here 45 degree. We have done. So this is above the HP. This is in the HP. So edge A and F should make 60 degree with HP. Now we will draw another XY line, or the XY line we will call it as AIP. So that we will take it with respect to this AF or this projector. The inclination of that line should be 60 degree. So I will reduce it up to here. This is AVP. Now I am drawing new XY line or new auxiliary inclined plane. I will use blue ink only. This line is inclined with respect to this. How much? 60 degree. So this is your AIP. AIP. On this we will be getting top view. Okay. This is front view. This is reduced front view. This straight line was top view. This again with respect to this, if we see this inclined line again, top view. Now we are getting front view. So project all this A, B, C, D, E, F points on this line and extend. How the projector should meet here at 90 degree. In that way we need to project. Okay. And extend. I am extending like this. So projectile distances may be more or less depending upon your accuracy and all measurements. I am taking some rough diagrams here, that's why it is like this. We will draw the front view, that is the final front view. Sorry, this is the top view, auxiliary inclined plane. We will be getting top view. This is final front view. This is here we are getting final top view. So let us see. I will use this color. A and F are on old XY line. So A and F will be on same XY line or same zero distance. Where is A? Here. So this is touching here. And F, where is F? Here is the F. So this two will be on the ground line only or on new XY line, that is called AIP. Now B and E, that is this point, B and E are some distance with this XY line. Okay, so this is B and this is E, small distance. That distance we will measure and we will transfer from this XY line this side. Small distance measurement and transferring from this line this side. So B and E are, this is the B, assume this is the B, that distance we have transferred here. Then where is E? E is here. So this is E, like this. So this is B and this is E. Then this distance, the longer one, which is C and D. C, D, common distance, this one. We will measure and we will transfer for D here and for C here. Now I will erase this flower brackets and we will join all the points with the scale straight line A to B, B, C, D, E, F and A. So this is the edge which is in the VP surface, making 60 degree with VP, and the edge by which it is resting with respect to HP is 60 degree. So this is the way you need to draw the auxiliary projections of planes. Okay, if you have any doubts you can put comment and solve the problem by step by steps. Don't do at a time. Okay.